north and swivel back to more tilter force. Sorry, I forgot the name of the game there for a second. But yeah, as you can see, we actually have more missions unlocked in Peru now. Previously, it was only just Insurrection, which we completed. But there are two new missions unlocked, Flood and Weatherman. Now, when I initially started playing this game, what I thought was that it only has like 5 missions, and I was a little disappointed because, as far as I had remembered, the Steam store page said 40 missions. Now, upon closer inspection and, you know, after having unlocked a few missions, I realized these are 5 whole different campaigns. Now, that is insane. To me, that is insane considering, you know, the level of modern games and how they deal with their campaigns. But yeah, this is gonna be fun. This is gonna be lots of fun. So without further ado, let's go ahead and start with the briefing for Flood. The object overview basically just capture all vehicles, equipment, and contraband at the enemy airfield designated objective raid. Flood and Weatherman. Sorry, I can't speak today. That's a nice little screenshot. Okay, so mission. Capture all vehicles, equipment, and contraband at the enemy airfield designated objective raid. Execution. From your insertion point, which would be this here, I suppose, proceed south along your checkpoints to a position in the foothills at the northeast end of objective Green. Eliminate all enemy resistance at the airfield. You're authorized to neutralize any enemy that you encounter. However, you're advised to avoid contact until you reach the airfield so as not to alert the forces there to your presence. This mission will be a success only after the objective has been secured. Expected enemy forces. Reconnaissance photos taken during a U-2 overflight of the objective reveal approximately 10 to 20 personnel manning stations on the airfield. The photos also show a small village approximately 240 meters north of the village. Okay, I guess that's where I'll be inserting. Chato believes this village may serve as housing for the personnel at the airfield. Another 8 to 10 men may be within or patrolling near the village at any time. Okay, that's good to know, I suppose. I like support. Alpha team will be inserted southwest of the objective, which would be this, I suppose. Sorry, my sense of directions are bad. And move into position in the hills 180 meters off the western flank of the airfield. Charlie team will be inserted southeast of the airfield and proceed into position in the hills 150 meters off the eastern flank of the airfield. Once Bravo team is inserted, both Alpha and Charlie will move forward to neutralize enemy positions and secure the southern perimeter of the objective situation. Special Operations Command has obtained a list of airfields suspected of being used by the druglord. Reconnaissance overflights of these sites have revealed an airfield north of Cusco, where a large shipment of drugs is being loaded onto an aircraft in preparation for shipment. The recent destruction of a major mercenary base in combination with the loss of this airstrip will severely restrict the druglord's operations. I guess they didn't take the hint and killed all the men. So what it seems like is that we've got a ring of enemy soldiers right here, and if this is indeed an insertion point or somewhere around here, that is, we probably should skirt around this area, skirt around this side to, you know, avoid any contact. This area seems to be on a plateau anyway, unless the darker parts of the map are, you know, higher. So there's no way of really knowing for good. In this game, I don't have much experience yet, but this seems to be a more sound approach instead of, you know, going through this one checkpoint here, and maybe take some observation point over here and just, you know, start blasting, I suppose. Anyway, but there was the village 240 meters north of the objective, so I'm guessing this somewhere around here is probably the village. I should probably avoid it because my primary objective is the airfield, so I'm guessing what I should do is I should come around and start here. That should give my allies as well a good chance of, you know, supporting me, so to speak of. And this mission seems to be about stealth, so these are all the weapons that I have available to me. I do not want the software of the mission, but I do suppose I will go for this one because it has a suppressor. Second. My apologies. Secondary, I will go for double load ammo because the rest of these weapons, they are, well, explosives. And we want, as far as I know, we want everything here to be intact. And of course, 0.22 suppressed is the proper, you know, way to go is what I feel like this mission, since at least for the initial part, stealth will be essential. So, but then again, there is a shootout once we are inside. So might as well not the Beretta light 50 caliber, not this either. I think I should stick with this instead, because once we're inside, it is mostly going to be a shootout. So yeah. And I'm dead. Of course I am.
Bravo is down. All units abort. All units abort.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to retry this level. Just one of the problems, you know, with not exactly playing strategically soundly in this game, or rather cautiously in this game. If you don't play cautiously, you are quite likely to injure yourself. I mean, that's where the shootout started last time, but I think I'm going to try and circumvent that, because I want to maintain the illusion of stealth until it is necessary to break it. There were also some points along the sky, on the map previously when we saw them. I think they were around the, you know, the checkpoint that I'm pointing towards right now, at the bottom, around that checkpoint. But I think I would rather prefer to circumvent them all right now. Yeah, we're going around this pillar. I'm carrying nothing, but I don't know if I can carry something in this game. Anyway. In case, you know, somebody decides to get the drop on me. I do not see any enemies thus far, but this is probably the village that I was briefed about. And what I think is I should go back a little and you know, circle along this side of the hillock, so that the villagers, they don't exactly see me and start shooting. And I don't think I'm supposed to be climbing this hill, but I'm much less dying on it. Well, that keeps my form concealed. Thus far, nobody can see me. Otherwise, they would have started shooting already. There are people there that I do not want to engage. I want to go this way. I want to go this way, which cuts across the hills. But I want to be a little smart about it. Let me just check out this village here. I mean, if there is anybody circling the area, the perimeter, then we might have to take them out a little more stealthily. Does not seem to be anybody here. So in case I decide to not show you guys what happened before this, I pretty much, you know, I played this mission once before and I died because it played me too aggressively. So I mean, no shame in that, but yeah, maybe I can, you know, take this approach. Wait, didn't I have yes, I did have binoculars. That's what I was wondering, because you usually have binoculars. Wait, so how do I zoom in and out again? Plus and minus, yeah. But this area seems to be clear this far. I mean, I don't see anybody here. So I guess we are free to keep moving forward. The .22 does not deal much damage, but it is suppressed, and that is, I suppose, what truly matters. So yeah, firefights these days reportedly take place in the distance between I see one man over there. One man, thus far nobody around these huts, at least. I can't say anything about who lives in them, but around them there's nobody. What should I do? I can take this one guy out silently, provided I don't get caught while going to him. I could probably, you know, take this path around, and I do suppose that is where I have to go anyway. Yeah, see, now there are enemies on top of that hillock in front, or maybe beyond it, what it seems like. And there's one guy who's guarding the pass. I think those people are beyond the hillock. So this guy is pretty much guarding the pass. However, there are other people that I need to be worried about at this point. But I think I'm super close to the airport at this point. So I might as well try using an alternative approach. Now I spy two other people here. Now what I think I can do is I can probably make a run for it, hidden among this village and go up this mountain, or you know, just take that guy out using the 22 pistol and make a run for it. However, there is another person over there who will see us. So maybe I can run up this hill and make that my base of operations. Should be within range of my target. And I don't think. Is that a person there? Is that a person there? Nah, seems like a bush. So, yeah, I suppose that is what we will do. We shall run up this hill and try to make it our base of operations. I hope that person does not see me. The guard over there, that is. He seems to be looking this way. Maybe he's not, who knows. Anyway, I'm just gonna risk it. Wish me luck, gentlemen. I am going to need it. Now, one of the things that I've realized about this game is that there are only two modes of walking. Sorry, movement. One of them is, you know, sprinting, and the other is walking. So what I'm doing right now, it's walking. What are those? Are those birds? Yeah, they are. How nice of them. So anyway, I do not want to run here in case there is somebody inside of these huts and they might wake up and hear me. So what I want to do is take things nice and slow. I will take this gun out just in case I do get into a firefight, although I do not expect to remain alive after all of this. But yeah. You know, just in case a firefight breaks out, I don't exactly expect to remain alive after that. Pretty sure that if I started talking as much as I am right now, in the middle of a mission like this, I would be long dead. Now, is that a person over there, is what I wonder. Yes, that is. That is a human being. There are two over there. That is bad news. I think those are the people I could see on the map. Yeah, those are. So one of them is on the pass here, two others are over on this side, and there's one person on top of this hill as well. So I need to be careful. I will take that person out on top of the hill. Who is out on top of the hill? Oh no. Okay, it's in a lot of fight right now. And what I need to do is get my ass into this ditch right here for some cover. Because I'm not surviving this otherwise. Now where did these guys go? Oh, right here. This was not how this mission was supposed to go, but god damn it. I have 15 rounds in the magazine, I'm going to utilize them as much as possible. I mean, I don't see this enemy, I do not feel his bullets whizzing past me. I do suppose I'm safe at this point. I don't exactly know where this guy is, but anyway. I think I made sort of a mistake, but the game was forgiving with what I did. Oh, yeah, right here. There you are. Get bullets in your face. Bleed. I keep pressing M for map, but I reassigned the key to tab. I mean, the map, the key for the map was supposed to be C. Actually, I had assigned it as C, but yeah. Anyway, I'll go up and I'll take this guy out. And yeah, that's what I'll do. I would like to be a little, you know, cautious. I did not expect those guards to actually come inside the village, but they did. And I guess that's just, you know, just how finely crafted this game is. Because, I mean, guards realistically should be coming inside, but just let, that guy is clueless about what's going on. Let him be that way. His friends are dead anyway. Let me just go ahead and reload here. Now, I'll just scout ahead in this area with the binoculars, just for the sake of it. And there should be somebody on top of this hill. I cannot see them yet, but hopefully I will be able to soon. I just hope that guy does not blindside me. Now, yeah, there should be somebody over here. Is that? No, that is not. That's a tree. It sometimes does not help that these older games have crappier graphics, but yeah, they are pretty finely crafted. You can't deny them that. The fact that they are very finely crafted. Yeah, so the mistake which I made back there is I think I should not have run from the village. It was providing me quite a lot of cover. I probably should have ran into a building and started, you know, defending my position from there. However, it all did work out in the end. So can't say that I'm complaining too much about that. Now, where is this guy, I wonder? He should be at the end of this. Ah, is he down there? Yes, he is. What are you doing, kind sir? Now this guy knows where I am.
This is Alpha, we're moving in position.
Charlie is at the perimeter.
Okay, I better lie down now. Was that somebody over there? Was that the guard that was trying to flank me? Is that guy trying to flank me? Anyway, you know what? I better move down this hill. Because I don't feel pretty too comfortable with that guy over there. Okay, okay, that's a lot of firepower headed my way, and I would rather be really safe. So, and my comrades are actually moving into position right now. So I can't exactly use them for cover. And looks like my comrades have arrived. I would actually like to change positions because my previous position is compromised. I would like to go up this hill right now. And one of the things that I want to be, you know, like I want to do is keep being on top of a hill, like near the top, not exactly at the top. I don't want to be silhouetting myself, but I do want to be on top of a hill and when I'm attacking, because that basically, you know, gives me a whole overlay of the land, gives me positional advantage, makes it more difficult for the enemies to hit me, especially when I'm lying prone. So that is exactly what I shall do, and I should stay at a comfortable range where they can't exactly get to me, but I can get to them easy. Yeah, okay, and I think everybody needs to be eliminated at this base here.
This is Alpha. South access is secure.
Is it now? Ah, but I see somebody over here. Wait, I can actually shoot while I'm reloading, what? I see somebody over there. Somebody who's taking shots. Oopsie daisies. Good thing that did not hit. Alpha team has secured the south axis. I don't know what happened to this guy, because I lost sight of him. That is Alpha 1. Maybe it is finally time that we move in. I do not see anybody else here. Oh yeah, just one last guy. Near this hangar, it would seem.
Hangar secured!
Oh, that was
this
it.
Is
like
perimeter secure.
Roger, Alpha.
It was sort of like a mission about.
Good job, Bravo. Move to the extraction point.
We done? Good. So this was apparently a mission where we clear a certain area, and yeah, those missions are usually interesting. And I apologize if the starting of this mission was a little boring, but yeah, that is pretty much how this game is. You need to be a little tactical about how you move, and how you shoot, and what you shoot. And when the firepower started, that was a lot of firepower focused on me, and if I have included the previous version where I died, you guys would know it's very difficult to actually, you know, survive in this game like you would in a Call of Duty game, even with the health bar on. So yeah, these games are open world for a reason. You can approach them approach the objective from any area you wish to, any side you wish to. And that is exactly what I like about these older games, and including the Operation Flashpoint games, except for Retro, but that was more linear, reminded me a lot of like a hybrid between Call of Duty and Medal of Honor. Anyway, moving on, we'll get to that game when we get to it. Let's go to debriefing now. Wait, what? Yeah, I got a zero kills because I sort of, you know, like, accidentally reset the mission. I pressed space without reading what it would do. But anyway, I can continue from this point on. I mean, successful. Thankfully, it has counted as a win. It did not count as failure. But anyway, the debriefing is: Bravo team has secured the druglord's airfield. A significant amount of drugs and weapons were captured in this mission. The remains of a code book were located in the command tent on the airstrip. While some information was recoverable from it, Jada believes full copy of one of these code books would be of great use to Delta Force operations. Bravo team will be dispatched to acquire a code book as soon as Jada can pinpoint a mercenary camp that might have one. Well, that's all for this mission, folks. I'll be completing the next few missions now as well. And until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.